Hello, this is Sister Charlene Winston, and I'm coming with you to you today with the Sunday School and Weekly Bible Study. Our lesson this week is Faith to Unite. Faith to Unite. It is a wonderful and great lesson we have this week, Faith to Unite. We are to seek God that we may have faith to unite with each other, because without His great blessings upon us, we do not have the faith to unite. We do not become close to each other. We stay apart. So we are to ask God to guide us and strengthen us in the faith of uniting with others. Amen. Our lesson, we'll be doing our lesson for Monday through Sunday. And we're going to first have a prayer, and then we'll get started in our lesson. Dear God in heaven, we do thank you. We thank you for watching over us and strengthening us. We thank you for leading us and guiding us in your true path of righteousness. We thank you for all the blessings that you have bestowed upon us, those seen and unseen. We come to you today asking that through your grace and mercy that our eyes is open that we do see, and our ears is open that we do hear and understand the wisdom and knowledge from your word this day, that we go forth and speak your word, that we go forth and be doers of your word and not hearers only. We pray that this lesson will touch each of us in a personal way, that we will allow this lesson to speak to our thoughts and our actions, that we may go forth and do your will and your way. In the name of Jesus Christ, we do pray. Amen. Our lesson begins on Monday with Put on the New Man. Put on the New Man. As we read the lesson, we realize that we have to make the step to put on the new man, to change, to become the new person that we are to be in Jesus Christ after receiving salvation, to grow up in maturity in Christ. We have to step forward and put on the new man. Going sitting in the pews and listening to the word does not put on the new man. The new man is put on by an act that we, each of us, have to personally step forward and do. Amen. Our lesson is coming from Ephesians, the 4th chapter, the 17th verse through the 24th. It says, "This I say, therefore, and testify in the Lord, that you henceforth walk not as other Gentiles walk, in the vanity of your mind." We are to not to walk as the people of the world walk. We are not to walk as those that claim Christianity and yet is not in Christianity. We are to walk in the newness of the mind of the Lord by putting on the whole armor of God, by putting His word in our thoughts and in our mind. It's a having the understanding dark and being alienated from the life of God through the ignorance that is in them, because they are deep in their own thoughts and their own beliefs, that they will not allow Jesus Christ to come in and renew their mind and renew their thoughts and their action. And because of the blindness of their heart is set in a way, and their mind is set in a way that they will not allow Jesus Christ to move in and to change them, who being past feeling have given themselves over to the lasciviousness, which is someone that is inclined to lust, to work all uncleanliness with greediness. When you are inclined to lust, when you are more apt to go after lust, it's not just lust of the physical means, but also of the outward mean of lust of things, instead of working towards our soul salvation. But you have not so learned Christ. You see, you is telling us that we didn't learn this of Christ. When we read the word, when we study the word, as we are to do, we do not see this in Jesus Christ as He walked among us. It's a, if so be that you have heard Him and have been taught by Him as the truth is in Jesus, if we have been taught by Him, if we have allowed the word to teach us and to work in us, then we are to change. We are to go forth and do the will of the Lord as He did. And we are to seek to walk in the status, the statutes of God our Father. so that you put off concerning the former conversation, the old man, which is a corrupt according to the deceitful lust, and be renewed in the spirit of your mind. How do we renew our mind? By putting the word of the Lord in us. And how do we put the word of the Lord in us? By reading the word. As we go forth and read the word, we meditate on the word day and night. As we walk in, instead of talking to ourselves or thinking to ourselves about things that are not of the Lord, but as we go forth and we put the word of the Lord in our spirit and we seek him out, then his word is in us. And we go forth and do his will. And that you put on the new man. The new man seeks after the Lord, seeks after doing what the Lord would have us to do, which after God is created in righteousness and true holiness. If we seek after God in righteousness and in true holiness, we will be doing and walking in the will of the Lord. Amen. Our Tuesday's lesson is live as imitators of God. Live as imitators of God. If we live as imitators of God, as we walk following Jesus Christ, then we are able to live as imitators of God. As Jesus Christ said, he do nothing of himself, only that of what his Father had told him to do. And as we walk after him, then we are doing what God would have us to do. Our lesson is coming from Ephesians 4, 25 through 5, 2. Ephesians 4, 25 through the 5th verse in the 5th chapter in the 2nd verse. It's the wherefore, putting away lying, speak every man truth with his neighbor, for we are members one of another, knowing that if we speak not lies against one another, as we go forth in our life against our neighbor. Who is our neighbor? Our neighbor is anyone that we come in contact with, that we are dealing with, whether on a regular basis or on a every once in a while basis. If we speak not lies one of another, because we are members one of another, we all are one. As it be, you angry and sin not. Let not the sun go down on your wrath. We are not to go to bed, with envy or hatred in our heart. We are not to turn in and be thinking of things that is evil or hateful against another. We are, when we lay down, we are to be meditating on the word. It said, neither give place to the devil. As we keep our mind in the correct manner of the will of the Lord, then we will not give place to the devil. But when we allow the devil to step in, then we do give place to the devil. And any inch he will take, as they say, he will take a mile. When stepping in any form, he shall go further. He said, let him that stole steal no more, but rather let him labor, working with his hands, the thing which is good, that he may give to him that needeth. As we labor among and do the will of the Lord, as we labor and work to make our finance, we are to help others that is in need of helping, and to bring them to the point where they are able to be helpers of others. As they said, you can give the man a fish and feed him for a day, but if you teach him how to fish, you feed him for life. Let us be teachers to teach others how to take care of and go forth and do for themselves. Let no corrupt communication proceed out of your mouth, but that which is good to the use of edifying. We are to, the things that we speak are to be building up. Edifying is to build up. We are to build up each other, that we may go forth and do the will of the Lord, to help each other to be stronger in what the Lord would have us to do, that it may minister grace unto the hearers. It helps, it builds up, it makes stronger those that are seeking to come closer to the Lord. We never know what a kind word does to a person that we speak to, whether in the store or at work or at home. We never know what a kind word does to a person, how it builds them up, how it lifts them up, that they may be kind and gracious to others as Jesus Christ is to us. And grieve not the Holy Spirit, whereby you are sealed unto the day of redemption. We are not to fall into a point of that we grieve the Holy Spirit with our speech, with our action, with what we do or how we do. Let us seek to do that which is of the Lord. to let all bitterness and wrath and anger and clamor and evil speaking be put away from you with all malice. All things that is not of Christ, all things that is evil, all things that cause anger, all things that evil speaking of, someone talking someone down, is not of the Lord. And it is malice, and it is pulling them down, and this is not edifying to the body. And said, be ye kind one to another, tenderhearted, forgiving one another, even as God for Christ's sake has forgiven us. As we forgive others, as Christ has forgiven us, then we walk more in the way of the Lord, because this is how Jesus Christ walked. He came that we may have life and life more abundance. And he came and he forgave even those that put him on the cross. As he forgives, then we are to forgive each other. And as he forgives us of our shortcomings and our sins and our iniquities that we do as we are changing and growing in him, we are to forgive others. It said, be ye therefore followers of God as dear children, and walk in love as Christ also has loved us, and has given himself for us, an offering and a sacrifice to God for a sweet smelling savor. As we go forth and we give ourselves to Christ, and he lives in us and we live in him, then we are able to go forth and do the will of the Lord. We are able to go forth and be doers of the word. And then we do send up a sweet smelling savor unto our Heavenly Father, which is Jesus Christ, who is in whom abides in us on an ongoing basis. And it builds him up in us that we become stronger in our faith and stronger in our walk with the Lord. Amen. Our Wednesday's lesson is Risen with Christ. Risen with Christ. And our lesson is coming from Colossians 3, verses 1 through 11. And the scripture lesson text reads, if you then be risen with Christ, seek those things which are above, which Christ sitteth on the right hand of God. Seek the things that look for, go after the things that is of the Lord, which is to be helpers one to another, which is to edify the body, which is to build us up. This is allowing us and giving us the ability to unite one to the other as we seek the things that are above and not things of the earth. Set your affections on things above, not on things of the earth. For you are dead and your life is hid with Christ in God. When you were baptized, when you went under the water, and you went under as unto death. And when you came up, you came up as living in Christ Jesus. And you are dead in sin. You are dead in unrighteousness. You are dead in doing evil. You are dead in doing things that's not of the Lord. And you are alive in Christ, and he is alive in you. It said, when Christ, who is our life, shall appear, then shall you also appear with him in glory. As when he come forth, and when he returns, then we shall be risen in him. And this is the Holy Spirit, the Spirit that lives in us, the Spirit that will be here for eternity if we take him on as our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. This bodily life that we have here is only for a short time, but the spiritual life that we have is for eternity. Mortify therefore your members which are upon the earth, fornication, uncleanliness, inordinate affection, evil concupiscence, and covetousness, which is adultery. We are to put aside all things that is not of Christ. Anything that does not walk or look as Christ does, we are to put it away, put it aside. And as many times we say, well, I can't change. This is what I've did all my life. But if we seek to change, if we go to Christ and say, Lord, I can't change this, but Lord, you help me to change. And he will help you to change. And it takes time. You won't change overnight. But if the more that you seek him, and each time that you do whatever it is that you may, that may not be of the Lord, each time that you perform this act and you ask him, Lord, help me to grow stronger and not doing it, you will get the ability to control. You will get the ability to change. And before you realize it, you will not be walking in this type of life, in whatever it may be that you're doing. For which things sake the wrath of God cometh on the children of disobedience. It say, in the which you also walked sometime when you lived in them. We all have been children of sin and of Satan. We all have walked in the life that was not pleasing to the Lord. But as we are changing, as we are moving forward in the will of the Lord, then we go forth. Then we become doers of the word. Then we not only we grow up from being children in the word to and taking milk, but we grow up to eating meat, the meat of the word, and doing more and becoming and our faith growing in the Lord. It said, but now you also put off all these: anger, wrath, malice, blasphemy, filthy communication out of your mouth. Anything that is unpleasing to the Lord, anything that is not of the Lord, we are to put aside, we are to put off, to take off, and we have to decide to do this. This is the main point of this lesson that we have to do. You have to be the one to decide to make the change. We have to seek the Lord that we do change in this form. It said, lie not one to another, seeing that you have put off the old man with his deeds. We are not to lie one to another, because when we do lie, that this is giving the devil a foothold in our life to do more and to have more to have more control of our life. If we allow the devil to stand up and allow him to speak through us and say things that is not true, then we give the devil a foothold in our life to cause more problems. And have put on the new man. We are not lying. We are not seeking malice of another. We are not lying on another. We are not speaking evil against another. It's a which is renewed in knowledge after the image of him that created him. We are renewed, and we are renewed in Jesus Christ, the one that created us, this that came and gave his life, that sacrificed for that we may have the opportunity of life eternal. It said, where there is neither Greek nor Jew, circumcision nor uncircumcision, barbarian, centurion, bond nor free, but Christ is all and in all. As we go forth, we are neither considered neither black nor white, nor Jew nor Gentile. We are all one in Christ. We are all one, and anyone that claims Jesus Christ as their Lord and Savior, we are one in him, and there is no separate reality in the what is going in our walk with the Lord. We are one body. We are one with the Lord. And as we move on, it said, as we are risen in Christ, now we move to, we are one body. We are many members. Our Thursday's lesson, we are one body. We are many members. This is the uniting of the Christian. This is the uniting of the church. No matter what gender or nationality or what religion we are claiming, we are one body in Christ. God did not come and die on the cross for the Baptist one time and the Pentecostal one time and the Jew one time. No, he died for us all. And when he died, we all have the right, and we all is raised in him in one spirit. And that one spirit that raised Christ from the dead is the one spirit that lives in each of us, whether Jew or Gentile, whether black or white, whether a different nationality or a different religion. He only died one time for us all. Amen. And it said, one body, many members. And this lesson is coming from 1 Corinthians, the 12th chapter, the 27th verse through the 31st verse. It said, now you are the body of Christ, and many, and members in particular. We are the body of Christ. Each one of us makes up the body of Christ. And we are, although that we are many members in particular, each has its own part, each has its own ability. And God has set some in the church, first apostles, secondary prophets, thirdly teachers, after that miracles, then gifts of healing, helps, government, diversities of tongue. With all of these, there is still many more that is not named. There are those that clean, those that cook, those that manage, those that take care of the children, those that is each one of us has a different gift of the, from the Holy Spirit. And that gift is the gift that we are to realize. That gift is all a part of one body. And so are all apostles, are all prophets, are all teachers, are all workers of miracles, have all the gifts of healing, do all speak with tongues, do all interpret, but covered earnestly the best gift. The best gift, my understanding is that the best gift is whatever the gift the good Lord has allowed us to have allowed us to work with, that gift we are to go forth in, that gift we are to use and to build up and to edify in the Lord and to help the body of Christ with this gift and this gift, and we are to go forth in this gift. And as we use that gift and in strengthening it as we go forth, then many times other gifts are added. And it's just like the parable that Jesus Christ gave of the men that he gave one he gave 10 cities to watch over, and one he gave 10 talents to hold, and the other he gave 5 talents to hold, and the other he gave 1 talent to hold, and the one that had 10 he made 10 more, and the one that had 5 he made 5 more. We are to take whatever the Lord has given us and to utilize it and then to build on it, to add to it. This is what we are to do with our going forth. I say, as we go forth in the Lord, we are to build on these things. Amen. Our Friday's lesson is honor the weaker members. Honor the weaker members. 1 Corinthians 12 through 13 and 22 through 26. 12 through 13 and 22 through 26. It said, honor of the weaker members. For as the body is one and has many members, and all the members of that one body, being many, are one body, so also is Christ. For by one Spirit are we all baptized into one body. We are all baptized into the Holy Spirit of Jesus Christ, and that body only. And there is not one, as I said earlier, one for the Jew or one for the Greek or one for the Gentile or one for the Baptist and one for the Presbyterian and one for the Pentecostal. No, it's one baptism. Whether we be Jew or Gentiles, whether we be bond or free, we have been all made to drink into one Spirit. We are all as in one. It said, nay, much more, those members of the body which seem to be more feeble are necessary. Even those that's not strong, even those that seem to fall along the way, we are to lift them up, we are to pick them up, we are to speak a word of encouragement, speak a word of guidance to each of these. We are to those weaker members, we are, they are just as important to the body as those that are in head, those that's in lead. For those members of the body which we think to be less honorable, upon these we restore more abundant honor, and our uncomely parts have more abundant comeliness. We are to seek to help those that seem to be fall by the wayside, seem to don't have the strength to grow in the Lord, just don't have the strength to change in the Lord. We are to still to speak to them, to seek to guide them, to lead them, that they become as strong as possible in the word, in the Lord. And they are very important to the building up of the church, because through them we show our love, through them we show kindness, through them we show that Jesus Christ does live in us. For our comely parts have no need, but God has tempered the body together, having given more abundant honor to that part which lacked. As he, those that are lacked, he's bestowed more upon. We are to put more into, we are to assist those more when needed. When they are in lack, we are to go forth and to help those that are in need. It said that there should be no schism in the body, but that the members should have the same care one of another. We should help one of the other. We not should not put one aside for the other. We should continue to help those that we can help. And whether one member suffer, all members suffer with it. Or one member be honored, all the members rejoice with it. As we go forth and we realize that in Jesus Christ, that as we help our brother and help our sister, that we, when we continue to help those that don't seem to grow or seem to go forward, we are building up the church. We are holding up the church because we all are one. We are one in Christ. Amen. And our saddest lesson, be of one mind. As we are many members and we are together helping and building up each other, and we are risen in Christ, and we do live as imitators of God, and we have put on the new man. Now we are going to make sure that we are of one mind. They say that it's not possible, but it is possible to have one mind. The one mind is mind to have love one for another, mind to serve one God. This is the mind that we are to be of one mind in. And this lesson is coming from 1 Peter, the 3rd chapter, the 6th verse through the 12th. It says, finally, be you all of one mind, having compassion one for another. Love as brethren. Be pitiful and be courteous. We are to be kind to one another. We are to love one another. We are to realize that everyone is not on the same level, not on the same stand that the other one is on. There are those that are built up to be the pastor, to be the apostle, to be the deacon, but there are those that are made to be the person that cleans up, the person that cooks, the person that watches the children, the person that teaches the children. Every member has its important part, and there is none that is lacking. And in each of these, we are to carry the compassion one for another, not rendering evil for evil or railing for evil, as Jesus Christ said that when he come, and he said, you say that, you know, you are to love those that love you, but I say to you, if you do this, you're doing this as the Pharisees do. We are to do it as Christ did, Jesus Christ himself did. We are to love one another without restraints on it, without if you're doing for me, then I do for you. Even the sinners does that. Even the sinners, you look at the drunkard, even the ones that's on the street that's drinking and all this kind of stuff, they know the ones that's going to give them a little sip of theirs when they got some, so they're going to go get him a sip of theirs. So when he got some and I ain't got some, he'll give me a, even they do that. We are to do more. We are to go surpass them by leaps and bounds. This is what we are to do. We are to do for those, and especially those that we know that will not do for us. But counterwise, blessed, knowing that you are thereunto call, that you should inherit a blessing, that we may inherit that blessing of eternal life, that we may continue to walk in Jesus Christ, and our faith is grown in doing for the Lord. It's for he that will love life and see good days, let him refrain his tongue from evil and his lips that they speak no guile. Let us hold our tongue in place. Let us guide our thoughts that we do not speak evil, because as we allow these things to come in our life and to take root in our life, it grows. It grows and it grows, and it becomes a part of us, and it becomes who we are. But as we put these in control, and we put that devil under our feet, we make Jesus Christ the Lord of our life. Let him excuse evil and do good. Let us move away from evil. Let us move away from backbiting. Let us move away from talking about our neighbors. Let us move away from doing things that's not of the Lord. It said, let him seek peace and ensure it. We seek peace. We look after peace. We look for peace. We even when it seems like it's impossible, we look for peace in every area of our life. For the one that gets on our nerve at work, for the one that bothers us and when we are trying to do good, for the neighbor that we really don't care for, let us seek peace in every area of our life. For the eyes of the Lord are over the righteous. We say we are righteous. We say we are sons and daughters of Jesus Christ. Then his eye is on us. Would anything that we're doing, that we're saying, would we want him to come back and see us doing this? Would we want him to to come on the day of his return, to come and catch us doing these things. As the parable that they gave in the Bible of the Lord left some over his vineyard, and when he come back, and he knew not the day nor the hour he was coming, but when he returned, he returned and he found him that he had beaten the servants, and he had misused the goods that he had put in his hand. This is the Christian. If we do not walk in the will and the way of the Lord, if we do not meditate on his word day and night, we do fall short. And his ears are open unto their prayers. Yes, his ears and eye, his ears is open to our prayers, and all things that is building up and that is good unto the Lord that we receive. Many times I've heard ministered many times that the Lord has given us our prayer, but there has been, and as we have read in the Bible, that there are things that come along and prevent us from receiving what the Lord has given us. Let us look to the Lord that we receive that which he has sent for us, that the blessing that we are asking for. And yes, as we get closer to him, then we would, the things that we pray for, the things that we ask for, will be things of the Lord, not things of the world. It said, but the face of the Lord is against them that do evil. He is against those that does not walk in the Lord, that does not speak or do as the Lord would have them to do. Amen. Then we move on to Sunday's lesson, which is a great and powerful lesson, as all of them is, faith to unite. Faith to unite. And it's coming from Ephesians, the fourth chapter, the first verse through the 16th. And the scripture lesson text read, I therefore, the prisoner of the Lord, beseech you that you walk worthy of your vocation, wherewith you are called. Whatever your vocation is, as I spoke of earlier, if your vocation is to clean the church, clean it with all your might. If your vocation is to minister in the church, minister with all your might. If your vocation is to minister on the street, minister with all your might. If your vocation is to heal on the street, heal with all your might. If your vocation is to minister to the children, lead the children, lead in all your might. Do it with all strength that you have unto the Lord. It said, with all lowliness, excuse me, that was the phone ringing, with all lowliness, with meekness, and with long suffering, forbearing one another in love. We are to do this in putting ourselves down to the point of knowing that we are one in Christ, that we are one in him, and that he did not lift himself above no one. He did not put himself greater than. He said, when you put yourself above, then you are least. If you want to be leader, if you want to be great in Christ, then you are to be low and meek. And say, endeavoring to keep the unity of the Spirit in the bond of peace. We are to seek to keep ourselves in the unity of the Spirit. How do we seek to keep ourselves in the bond of the Spirit? By reading the Word, by searching the Word out, by looking to the Lord and speaking to him and asking him for guidance in our walk with the Lord. It said, there is one body and one Spirit, even as you are called in one hope of your calling. We are called in one body. We are called in one Spirit. And we are called, and then in that calling, we are to seek and to endeavor to do that which the Lord would have us to do. And we are to do it with all our might. And this unites the body of Christ. This builds up the body of Christ. It said, one Lord, one faith, and one baptism. No matter who we are and where we are in the Lord, there is only one Lord. There is only one faith. There is only one baptism. And that is into the Holy Spirit. And the Holy Spirit that dwells in us, that lives in us, that comes into us when we die to self and die to sin. We in one Spirit is the Holy Spirit that raised Jesus Christ from the dead. And that Spirit lives in each of us. It's that one God and one Father of all, who is above all and through all and in you all. If we are in Jesus Christ, we are in God. because God is in Jesus Christ, and we are all one, and we are to walk as he walked, and we are to have the mind of Christ. We are to have one mind of love, one mind of care, one mind knowing that we serve one God. It said, but unto every one of us is given grace according to the measure of the gift of Christ. We are given grace according to the measure of the gift of Christ. This entails and empowers us that as we grow in the Lord, as we move forward in the Lord, and as they say, we grow faith to faith. As we grow in our faith, and how do we grow in our faith? By doing the word. And this builds up our faith. This moves us forward. And we are not having faith in our faith. We are having faith in God. We are building up our faith in God. We are building up our faith in Jesus Christ, the one that we walk with and we walk talk with. We are building up our faith in him. And as we build up this faith grows faith to faith. But unto every one of us is given grace according to the measure of the gift of Christ. Wherefore he says, when he ascended on high, he led captivity captive and gave gifts unto men. And said, when Jesus Christ went up to the Heavenly Father, he went up on high, and he also, when he went up on high, he took captivity captive. He took control over sin. He took control over lying. He took control over death. He took control over backbiting. He took control over stealing. He took control over all evil things. And we are to put them under our feet in Jesus Christ. It said, now that he ascended, what is it but that he also descended first? He went down into the lower parts of hell and took control over sin, took control over death, took control over all things. How did he take control over sin? That we may have the opportunity to in him that we sin not, that we may through his blessed mercy that we live eternally in Jesus Christ. This is what we are. We are alive in Christ. And when this body is gone, we shall still be alive in Christ. This is the eternal life that we speak of. He that descended is the same also that ascended up far above all heavens, that he might fill all things. When he descended and took control ascended and took captivity captive and went into heaven to where his Father was, everything was under control at that time. Now all we have to do is walk in it. All we have to do is accept it and believe in it and make it our life, make it our substance for us. It said, and he gave some apostles and some prophets and some evangelists and some pastors and some teachers. All of us have our own and personal gift that Jesus Christ has given us. And these are just a few that is named. Those that clean the church, those that take care of the building of the church, those that take care of the children in the church, those that take care of the finance of the church, all these other ministries that's in the church, whatever we are doing, we're to do it to the glorification of God. And as even when we take care of our family, our friends, we're to do it to the glorification of God. And as we do and go forth, we are building up our faith in Jesus Christ. It said, for the perfecting of the saints, for the work of the ministry, for the edifying of the body of Christ. These that are these that has these titles are there, are put there to build up, to show us, to guide us in what we are to do. And we are not to go and receive the word and sit at home and not change. We are to receive the word and go and be doers of the word. We are to receive what the pastor has said to us. We are to receive what the teacher has said to us. We are to go forth and be doers of what we have learned. It said, till we all come in the unity of faith and of the knowledge of the Son of God, until the day that Jesus Christ returns, then we are to go forth and to be doers of the word. We are not to sit around and wait, well, I'm going to wait till he comes. No, we are to be doers while we are waiting on him to come. Whatever he has us to do, do it with all the might and all the strength that you have. It's unto a perfect man, unto the measure of the stature of the fullness of Christ. We are to be striving to become more and more perfect, more and more like Jesus Christ. How do we know when we're becoming more and more like Jesus Christ? By reading the word and know who he was and what he was and how he walked and the way he walked, and we are to strive to walk in that manner. It said that we henceforth be no more children tossed to and fro. When we began our walk with Christ, we are children in Christ, but we are to grow up. We are not to remain children. We are to grow up and be able to partake of the meat of Christ, the building up of the family of church of Christ, the building up of the church of Christ, whether it be inside the building or outside the building, wherever we may be working the will of the Lord, that we should be doing it with all our might. And said, tossed to and fro and carried with every wind of doctrine. As beginners, many times we are tossed to and fro more and more than we ever was. But as we get strong in the Lord, as we grow in the Lord, and to grow in the Lord, we must seek the Lord and seek his word. By the sleight of men and cunning craftiness, whereby they lie in wait to deceive us. If we do not get the word in us and get the word in us strong, when we are first receive the Lord, we can be as the power that he gave us, that we are like the farmer that planted, and some fell on rock, and some fell on sand, and some fell on different things, and but only that fell on good ground that was able to sustain. Let us make sure that where the word of the Lord fall on us, that we take hold of it and we move forward and we in our life make it strong and make it and build it up. We have to do this. This is our personal job in the Lord. It said, but speaking the truth in love may grow up in him in all things, which is the head, even Christ. If we speak the truth, if we speak it in love, not trying to be hateful, not trying to be mean, not in our sly way, in our own way, talking about someone by telling the truth, telling it to hurt their feeling, telling it to cause them harm or pain, then if we speak the truth in love, then we grow up to be as Christ was, as he did when he walked the streets. It said, from whom the whole body fitly joined together and compacted by that which every joint supplies. Every body is very important to the body of Christ. There is none that's not important. No matter where you are in Christ, you are important to the body of Christ. Do not feel that where you are in Christ does not make a difference, does not make a change, that you can't speak to nobody because I haven't learned the whole Bible. I don't know scriptures to quote, and I don't know verses to give out. You ain't wherever you are in Christ, you can build up somebody else. Use what you have and go forth with that. It said, by that which every joint supplies according to the effectual working in the measure of every part, maketh increase of the body unto the edifying of itself in love. It increases the body. It builds the body up. It causes more members. It causes the members to become stronger as we build up ourselves in the Lord. And this is what we are to do. This is how we are to walk in Christ Jesus. And we are to become closer. Let us go forth and have the faith to unite. It takes faith to unite. Let us make a specific effort to unite with others. Let us make a specific effort to help others. Let us make a specific effort to show love one to another. Amen. I pray that you meditate on this great and powerful lesson we've had this week. And y'all have a wonderful and blessed week.